Hello guys, welcome to IQ Pop. In this video, I will discuss DBMS, Database Management System, in short. So first is data. So what is data? So from the beginning itself, we started hearing the term data. So data is nothing but some raw value. So it may be anything that when we add something, or when we attributize that raw value with something, then we called it is information. Say if I say 65, so 65 is data. You can't imagine what is this 65 about, but if I say, okay, this student got 65 in mathematics, so you can understand, okay, 65 is marks, right? So only 65 is data, all right? Next is database. So what does it mean by database? That word is similar, like we say airbase, military base. So what does it mean? It means that airbase means where the aircrafts are going to be landed, and lots of aircrafts can be, you know, rest there. And if you think about military base, that there is lots of troops of military can stay there. So in the same way, the database is a place, a software, which stores lots of data, huge collection of data together. Okay. So next, we call it database management system. So what is database management system? So management, by this word, a management system, by this term, we can understand that it allows us to manage the data what we have stored in the database. Alright. So what management it allow? It allows us to enter new data, to manipulate existing data, to delete existing data, or anything you want to do, want to access the data or anything. So it allows us to manage the data in every way you want. So database is a very large integrated collection of data, and a database management system, or DBMS, is a software designed to store, manage and facilitate access to database. Now some application of DBMS. Online banking we all use. So where is our data is stored when we access the online banking website? So from somewhere that website display our account information, statement, everything. So from where it is taking the data and putting in front of us? So there is some database behind it, from where the website is retrieving data and showing to us. So another is e-commerce application, and most popular is Amazon. So if you, when you browse through Amazon, you will find for each product lots of information are, you know, available there, including review, features of product, technical feature, everything. So where is this data stored? So there is some database where all these data are stored. Gmail, where does our mails are stored? Yeah, they are stored in some database server. WhatsApp, Aadhaar, the most popular term nowadays, discussing everywhere. Aadhaar, you need to link Aadhaar to some our say bank account, to our gas connection, anywhere. So how this data of Aadhaar is going to be connect to our bank account and any other account? So there is database, other database, where our data is saved, and it gives access to the bank or other authority to authenticate the person. Facebook, every day we are posting millions of pictures, post, comment, like. So all these things are going to be stored in some database. Some applications, more applications. So data warehouse is one of the very important application. Data warehouse is nothing but it is a special kind of database which stores historical data, say last 5 years or last 10, 20 years data. Document management, storage, backup, reporting tools, business intelligence, and app integration. Some database softwares: Oracle is one of the most popular. MS Access, it comes with MS Office. SQLite, it is for Android app development, who develops an Android app or iOS app, they know this is quite popular. IBM DB2 comes from IBM. MySQL, one of the free DBMS software. And SQL Server comes from Microsoft. So, who is where? So, say we have a database. So, we need application software to access the database. We means here general user. Say we are the user of online banking, we are the user of some e-commerce website. So these websites are kind of application software. So application software helps us to retrieve data from the database, and it presents the data in front of us. So that application software, yeah, here you can see it may be some mobile app, it's maybe through, you know, tablet, laptop or anything. Or some end user, say, it may be some person who is going to enter the data, say, some customer care person, or say, some person at the bank counter. You have deposited some cash, he is, depositing the cash to your account, is entering the data to the server. So he is also having some application software, and through this application software is entering the data to DBMS. Now on the back end, what is happening? There is some database administrator who is administrating the database, is controlling everything, who will get access to the database, who will not get access to the database. Everything is under him. Database design, there is another team who is going to design the database, right? So how to store the data, where to store, how many tables will be there, all these things are headache of the database designers. Next is system administrator. How to see this, the database is software, as we are saying, so it is going to be installed on some system. So we need some system administrator who will maintain that system. Okay, so there is some system administrator. So there is lots of people are working at the background or at the back end of the database. We never feel so when they are using the system software or application software as a end user. We never feel that in background how many teams are working there. Now, manual file system versus computer. So you can understand that when database was not there, even computer was not there, we used to maintain everything in manual files. Still you will find some in some offices and in some minor cases, people are still using this kind of files. Okay. So what are the problem if we use this kind of files? One problem is tracking the file, updating the file, it may be multiple copy of same file. So that is what duplication, we call it duplication. That means it may be multiple, we have forgotten that previously we had opened a file for that particular reason. Now again we have opened another file, so it is going to be duplication. Inconsistency. So there is two files for a particular work, we are updating the things, or somehow we have forgotten to update something in both the file. They have updated one file, they forgotten about another. So it is going to lead us to some inconsistency. Rigidity. Yes, it is rigid. We can't transfer the file to one place to another place. We can change the existing data in the file if we need. If we need to manipulate the thing, it is not possible here. Wastage of space. So on computer, what is going to happen, that for everything we are going to generate one file. So if you look at the old mobile phones, so what where Android was not there, you will find there we had a limitation of storing how many phone numbers we can store there, or how many text messages or SMS we can store there. There is some limitation on it. Reason is that for every contact detail, it is going to create a new file, okay? And for every SMS, it is going to create a new file, and how many file that OS of that phone can handle, it is defined, it is predefined. Okay, so after that, it for this operating system or the for the small phone, it is not possible to access any more files. But in case of, you know, Android phones or latest mobiles, we find that we can save limitless or any number of contact detail or any number of SMS, emails, everything. Reason is that they are going to store in some database. Data inaccuracy. So it happens because we can't manipulate data once or somehow. If you enter some wrong data by mistake, it is going to remain there. There is no automated mechanism to cross-check it. So inaccuracies are going to be there. High overhead of data manipulation and maintenance. So if there is, you know, small files in the computer, every time if you want to manipulate the data, change the data, update the data, it is very hard because you have to go to that file, search that file, open that file, again change the things. So it is very hard. So there is high overhead regarding this. Now, database system versus file system. So here you can see a file system. So file system is going to be stored on the disk storage, and operating system is going to be there to access or allowing you to access the file system. And we need some interface through high level language through which interface will access these files and allow us to retrieve data from this file system or manipulate the data. And later, after that, we need some application program through which user will work. Okay. On the other hand, if there is database is going to be installed on the operating system, and there is DBMS, that is database management system, which is interfaced with some application program through some interface, or you can say it is interfacing through some high level language. So here we are having a website, here we are having a DBMS. So this website is designed in JSP, and this is a MS Access database or Oracle database. We can have JDBC or DBC here to link and interface between this, and user are going to access this application program or website which is designed in JSP. Okay. So this is the basic difference regarding access of this two-tier system. Now, evolution of data models. So before 1960, there was only manual file handling, that is hard copy. In 1960s, first file-based concept came. That means we started keeping our data in computer, but in files. Like still we do, say we need to store a little bit of data, say someone's contact temporarily, we open that text editor and we paste here, we say type somebody's detail, contact detail or others, and save it for temporarily. So still we use it, but in very, very small scale, but that time it was fully file based. And in 1970s, first hierarchical network database model came. Next, in 1980s, relational entity relational database came, which is also called entity relationship database. Okay, the data model. This is still very popular and being used everywhere. This is so good concept. Relational model. When 1990s, when everything is going to started converting in the concept of object oriented, so that time the database also object oriented model came. And what happens in object oriented model? In object oriented model, any real life entity or any real life object is going to be treated as a class here. So in the same way, it is going to be described by some attributes. So in 1990s, that object-oriented data model came. In 2000, web-based data model came. But still, I must say here, this relational data model is most important, and we are going to cover this thing later in detail. Why to study databases? Because first thing is that we are shifting from computation to information. So previously, the computers was supposed to compute something, give you some result, some simple process. But nowadays, what is happening? We have data, we have historical data, but we need valuable information out of it, what is called data mining. So we need good information. Based on that, we can do business decision making. We can make lots of decisions. We can forecast the weather. We can forecast anything. We can detect who is going to win in the pool, anything. Enterprises are hugely using database every day because every day they need to store all the data, purchase data, sale data, logistic data, everything. The scientific, so NASA and any other scientific organization and lots of biological data, gene data is going to be stored in a database and they need to access efficiently to analyze them. So we need database allow that thing, access efficiently and manipulate them very easily and giving a result faster. And definitely personal uses. Even in our smartphones, there is database to store the contact detail, the SMS. So in personal life and personal use also, we are using databases every day. Purpose of database management system. So it handles the following things. First is data redundancy and inconsistency. Next, difficulty in accessing data. It makes the thing smooth, accessing data. Data isolation, manipulates file and format. So all these things was a problem in the file system, but database system reduces or handles this thing, removes this thing. Integrity problem. So in file system, there was lots of questions of integrity. If some data is at multiple places, the shared data, what about the integrity? But database management system guarantee you the integrity of data. Automaticity of update. So the same thing, if I updated something, some shared data which is used by multiple objects, then what about the updation? If I am updating for one, does it going to be updated for others? It must be guaranteed. So database management system give that guarantee. Concurrent access by multiple users. So database management system gives concurrent access to multiple users. Say to your account, somebody is depositing some money at the bank account, at the bank counter, at the bank branch. At the same time, somebody is withdrawing some money from bank ATM at the same time. So at the same time, your account is going to be accessed by both the people, by the bank counter person and somebody who is using your ATM card. But database supports both of them, serves both of them. That is called concurrent access. Security. So databases assures you security of the data. Now, there is ACID property. Very beginning, we should remember that there is four property of database which must be satisfied in every cases. Then only the database design is going to be called a good database design. So first is called atomicity, so which ensures even if system crashes in the middle of transaction, nothing is going to be lost. That means, say, from your bank account, you have withdrawn money. Say, it was 1 lakh balance. You have withdrawn 20,000. And at the before updating that 1 lakh minus 20,000, the balance will be 80,000. Now, before writing this 80,000, say, there was a power cut. So, does it mean that when the machine will be restarted, it will show you 1 lakh balance? No, there should be assurance from the database that even it was not able to write that or updated the balance from 1 lakh to 80,000, but when it will be restarted, it will be written. Okay, so that must should be there. Next is consistency. each transaction executed completely must take the database between consistent state or must not run at all. So whenever we are going to transact something, it must be in some consistent state. Either it is going to execute as a whole, or otherwise it will not execute at all. DBMS ensures that concurrent transactions appear run in isolation. That means, say, two person is withdrawing money from a single account at the same time. Database must assure that both the deduction of the money or both the withdrawal of the money will be updated in the balance of the account, and that must be granted. That is what called isolation. Durability. So it is committed transactions even if system crash. Then also the transaction must be committed, means completed at any cost, either after system crash or any situation. It must assure that one. Advantages of a database management system. First is data independence, efficient data access, data integrity and security, data administration, concurrent access, crash recovery, reduced application development time. But why not every time they use DBMS to develop application? Reason is that it may become expensive or complicated to set up and maintain the software. This cost and complexity must be offset by need, general purpose, not suited for special purpose task, say like textures. So the path of developing a database, first is proposal or requirement analysis. Next, we'll normalize the modeling, the schema design, we'll design in pen and paper, you can say how we are going to develop the database. So that is, that planning is called designing. Next, implementation, you should create tables, indexes, queries, optimization, everything according to our design. Once it is implemented, we must go for testing that whether there is some inconsistency anywhere, whether it is supporting the ACID property, whether it is assuring security, everything. Once it is testing, everything is done, we are going to install it for the use. Okay, thank you for watching. Like, comment and share and subscribe, and hang on with me to get more videos like this.